Welcome back. You're watching Commodity Champions, and joining us on the show now is Surinder Mehta, who's National Secretary at India Bullion Jewelers Association. Mr. Mehta, hi. Thank you so much for joining us. The FM in the last budget had announced developing gold as an asset class. There was also a talk about tweaking the gold monetization scheme and also the launch of the gold spot exchange. All the steps for the industry and in the right direction. But where are those promises? Where are we there? How much really has been done in the last 1 year?
Truly speaking, out of all the three, there has been some progress definitely in respect of setting up of the spot exchange. The government is almost in the final stage of appointing a regulator. And once we all know that the regulator is appointed, the spot exchange will find its way in the next 6 to 8 months. As far as making gold as an asset class is concerned, I don't think much has been done about it. We have been constantly requesting government that all asset class should be treated as at par, and that is what the asset class actually means. So we have always been telling government that to buy the gold also, the loan should be available, like in case of a car or a real estate business. As far as tweaking the gold monetization scheme is concerned, I think it will find its way once the gold policy is announced. The government is in the final stages of announcing the gold recycle or the gold monetization scheme, which we are hoping that it will be linked to that income tax circular number 1916 of 1994, where a woman can deposit of 500 grams of gold and no question should be asked. So once this is done, there would not be any fear of depositing gold under the gold monetization scheme. So I would say that yes, not much has been done, but definitely it all takes a little time to progress in respect of changes of policy, etc. So we feel that before the new budget is announced, that is budget 2019 is announced, the draft gold policy will be on the table.
Mr. Mehta, also another concern for the industry has been the credit finance in last 1 year, as the banks have had an issue with your sector, with what happened with the diamond industry. How much of that impact has come in for the bullion and jewelers? And are you looking at some correction for that also from this budget?
See, as far as gold industry is concerned, our demand has always been that please look at these are two different industry. One is gold industry, another is diamond industry. Lot of problems have arisen in this industry because of the diamond dealers, diamond trade, and the people who have been round-tripping the exports, etc. in case of diamond. But if you look at the gold is a commodity where the exports are based on international pricing, and I think if the banks are looking at gold and diamond as a one sector, I think probably they are making some mistake. Gold is a much better industry to be believed, and definitely the banks can have a lot of control because of its price mechanism, because of purity verification and other details. So I think government will take necessary steps to improve the working capital finance, gold metal loan finance in respect of gold trade.
Mr. Mehta, the other areas of focus clearly have been the bank, bullion bank rather, the gold policy, a gold regulator, the ATM card for bullion. What is the clarity on those? Because we have been talking about all of this in last couple of years. Do you see this budget pushing forth for these sectors also?
Definitely. See, bullion bank and spot exchange, these are our two major demand as far as this year budget is concerned. Spot exchange though already announced in the last year, but the bullion bank, because once the bullion bank is announced, bullion banks can start gold saving accounts, gold recurring deposit account. The money received can be credited to the person's account in form of gold quantity. The same gold quantity can be used to fund the jewelers, which will act as a working capital finance or the gold metal loan finance for the jewelers. So I think bullion bank is the way the future of the industry, the business of this industry must be carried out. See, also important is that what we really need, that like the rupee credit card or debit card account, there should be a bullion or a gold credit card or a debit card once the bullion bank is established. So that will make it very easier for the account holder to buy the jewelry from the respective jewelry shops.
Well, the cheer for the gold prices clearly is in the Indian markets, where we've seen the prices at a five-year highs, multi-month highs in the global markets also. While it, of course, is good for the investors who already have bought gold, but when it comes to new investments, when it comes to jewelry demand, that has seen a decline. Would you say that 2019 perhaps could be a better year for that too?
See, if you look at the import figures, you will find that the import has reduced by 120 tons in the last calendar year in comparison to 2017. So somewhere government has been successful in bringing the import down. And but as far as jewelers are concerned, nothing has changed much because the overall consumption does not seem to have changed. It means more gold is coming in for the recycling. We need to understand that government will always try to reduce the import and will always try to see that the household gold comes into the system. And this is the way the future of the industry really is. The price discovery, the transparency can only come if all these things are put together through a gold policy mechanism.
All right, Mr. Mehta, before we let you go, what are you putting out as your budget wish list? What is your expectation this time around, as if you had to lay out some three key priorities?
What we want basically, that jewelry is a big market in India. So government should set up a lot of jewelry parks, a cluster for domestic as well as for the export purpose. And they should be world class. We can definitely promote the handcrafted jewelry through these jewelry parks. So we have also requested for the reduction in the GST in respect of handcrafted jewelry and removal of GST on the job work charges. See, once these jewelry parks are made, the international market for the jewelry will be open. And I think some state government has definitely taken the initiative, but nothing concrete has yet been done in respect of this. But the Haryana government, Madhya Pradesh government, Maharashtra government, they have already announced the land for the jewelry park. But we still have to see the real jewelry park.
And do you not expect the import duty cut at all coming in this time? Do you see a rationalization or a cut? Because that has been a demand, of course, for many months, many years rather now.
See, as far as import duty is concerned, let me tell you that import duty reduction actually helps jewelers, but it does not help the people who have invested in sovereign gold bond, people who are holding the household gold. Today, when you count your household gold, you also include duty part of it, and you get money for that duty also if you sell that jewelry or the gold. So I don't think government will please these 3 lakh jewelers and will annoy those 130 crore population. I don't think duty reduction is on its way. Yes, it is possible in the phased manner, and I think 1% duty reduction per year will be more than enough. So that it does not disturb the investors, it does not disturb the household also.
All right, Mr. Mehta, we'll let you go at that. Well, that clearly is the bullion expectation, or a wish list rather, from the finance minister on the budget that is going to be presented on 1st of Feb. And that brings us to our last guest on the show, Mr. Mrugang Paranjpe, who is the MD and CEO at Multi Commodity Exchange. Mr. Paranjpe, hi, thank you so much for joining us. While, of course, everybody is putting out their budget wish list from the finance minister, what are your expectations? What are you looking forward from, as in sense of a derivative exchange this time around?
So I think, Manisha, in fact, since last year, we have not really raised the issue of CTT. We understand the rationale at which it was introduced. We also understand why it is difficult for the policymakers to move away from a tax like the CTT. However, we believe that there's a genuine demand from the members, which is to restore the Section 88E benefit. And I think that's something which we are hopeful will happen during the budget process. That's something which we really want. In addition to that, I think at the last budget, the government had announced the initiative around launching of a spot gold exchange. We are very hopeful that whatever other policy measures need to be taken to get that to fruition will happen in the next couple of months, definitely. So I think those are our two expectations for the policymakers.
Your point is well taken. As you said, after CTT, we have seen the participation decline quite a bit, and you are getting those numbers back now. But from where we stand right now, on a quarter-on-quarter or a year-on-year basis, how have the participation has been on the exchange? And what is your sense on where will we see more numbers coming in from?
Participation has been on the increase. The number of unique clients who trade on the exchange in a full year, last year it was 271,000. This year we are about to cross that number as we speak. So, in less than 9.5 months, we have achieved a full year's participation in terms of the unique clients that trade on the exchange. I think that has been the biggest driver for this growth in the volumes, because this has been possible on account of our members combining their operations between equity and commodities, that leading to economies of scale, as well as to a larger sales force being available. We are getting the immediate little impacts now of some of the bank distribution also coming on board, but that's really not happened in a big way. So we only have one bank distributor still active on the exchange over the last 3-4 months. But I think it's the widespread participation which has led to the overall increase in the turnover.
Okay, so Mr. Paranjpal, let's take in a question on the road forward as well. What expansion are you looking at? In what areas, what products, measures are you expecting from the regulator as well? Because the budget will bring about what it has to, but SEBI, of course, has been opening up this market in sense of custodial services, in sense of banks being allowed. And of course, now we have index trading as well on the radar. What are your expectations from 2019 now?
The next quarter, I think there are a couple of things which we are expecting. One, in terms of our product portfolio, we want to expand in both the energy and the non-ferrous space and the ferrous space, where we are looking to increase at least one contract each in the next quarter. I think in terms of a completely new product, I think we are very hopeful that index trading will come in definitely in the next quarter. From an institutional development, I think with SEBI having sort of sorted out the custodial participation issue in the last board meeting, we are very, very hopeful that in this quarter we will see mutual funds, PMS providers being approved to participate in the commodity derivatives market. So I think from an expansion perspective, we definitely see more products and more participants coming in. On the distribution side, at least two more bank subsidiaries are expected to go live within the next 15 days, and that would really increase the overall distribution that we are seeing as well.
All right, Mrugang, we'll let you go at that. Thank you so much for joining us. Well, we brought to you today the wish list from the commodity derivative markets, from the bullion side and the farm and agriculture as well, on what all of these sectors are looking forward to from the budget on 1st of Feb. That's all the time that we have on Commodity Champions. Thank you for watching.
गेम ऑफ चॉइस में अब ईशा की बारी. ईशा चॉइस वन. फेमस शेफ नहीं बनोगी पर जो चाहे खा सकोगी.
नेक्स्ट.
या फेमस शेफ बनोगी पर डायबिटिक भी.
ये कैसे ऑप्शंस हैं?
यू हैव टू चूज.
वुल पिक डायबिटीज यार.
व्हाटएवर.
अनफेयर.
ऑब्वियसली
हेल्थ और सक्सेस दोनों चाहिए ना, तो सक्सेस ढूंढते हुए हम सेहत को क्यों भूल जाते हैं? करियर के साथ आप हेल्थ पर भी हमारे प्लान मुताबिक ध्यान दीजिए, और हम आपको हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस प्रीमियम पर 30% तक रिटर्न्स देंगे. कॉल फॉर एन आदित्य बिरला हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस एडवाइजर. आदित्य बिरला कैपिटल.
व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन यू टर्न सिंपल स्ट्रेट लाइंस इनटू अ मास्टरपीस? यू गेट स्टनिंग किया कार्स. बट व्हाट ऑन अर्थ इज दिस एस्ट्रोनॉट डूइंग हियर?
Policymakers, regulators, and decision makers deliberate on ways to keep our nation secure, recognizing excellence and innovations of CSOs and security officers. Watch IFSEC India Awards only on CNBC TV 18.
Zara si hasi, dular zara sa.
Amul, the taste of India.
Zara si andan, pyar zara sa.
Yeah. ICICI Prudential Life Insurance and CNBC TV18 present Mission Insure India. Life insurance for all.
This is TV18 and you're watching CNBC TV18.
Presented by Standard Chartered. Digital partner Jio. In association with Mint. Media partners Lakshya.
Hello and welcome to the first of our pre-budget specials at the CNBC TV18 India Business Leader Awards. The finance minister almost launched a budget curtain raiser by hinting that a relief package for the farm sector is merited. To discuss how such a relief package may be provided in a vote on account and what impact that may have on the economy and more importantly on the cost of capital, I'm joined by the former chief statistician and renowned economist, Dr. Pranop Sen, Suyash Chaudhary of IDFC Mutual Fund, Abhishek Upadhyay, the economist from ICICI Securities primary dealer, and Anant Narayanan, professor at the SPGen Institute of Management and Research. But first, gentlemen, welcome. Let me start by first playing to you the key statements made by the finance minister regarding the upcoming vote on account and possibly an interim budget.
Fiscal prudence and fiscal discipline is something which gets rewarded in the larger interest of the economy. Of course, there could be unusual situations where you will have to